So in this chapter, we'll create fluid source for the tree. So just make another geonode. Our geometry node, and we'll give it a color as green, and I'll rename it to source. So dive inside it, and we'll take object merge, and we'll hide other objects, and we'll bring in the tree. So now we have the tree, and we'll start development for the fluid source. So first of all, just create a group. So we need the upper part of the tree to get for burning. So we'll create a group and we'll rename it as up. The group type will be primitives, and we'll take a bounding box. So now we'll adjust the bounding box. And we'll keep the bounding box in the upper portion of the tree. So now it is looking fine. So as you can see, we have made the group. And now we'll color it as black. So just give the values to 000, and you have got black color. Now we'll take a attribute transfer, because we want to transfer the color from one geometry to another. So now take a sphere. And keep somewhere side by the tree. So now adjust the sphere, and we'll give it a color as red. So we want to transfer red color to the black. So now you can see the color is transferred from one geometry to another. So just take the destination group as up, and then the points, you have to transfer the color, so just take the color. So we have distance threshold, so which gives like up to how much distance the color should transfer. So by increasing, the color will transfer to more farther, and by less, it will transfer up to the less distance. So as we have to animate distance threshold. So we'll take a mountain node. So we want some kind of noise. So it's just up to you, like how you want to keep it. So here in time, I'll just give a $t, which will animate the noise. So now we'll just animate the distance threshold also. So in the first frame, we'll keep it as 0 and Alt and click. So it just gives a key and we'll keep up to 75 frame, or let's keep to 70. And we'll give up to 28. So now you can see the color transfer is also animated. So as I need two spheres, so these are just artistic decisions. So now it is looking good. So just adjust the sphere. So now we'll just scatter some points in the tree. So create a scatter node, and you can see we have scattered some points. So here we want to scatter onto the color. So we'll give CD. So now it is. So now the points are scattered to the color. And we'll give it to group because we want to scatter the points in the proper bounding region or the group we created. So we'll create more points for better details. So you can just click on relax iterations, so it will bring some kind of jitter. It won't be uniform, it is non-uniform. So now we'll delete the color attribute. So now I'll just create a file cache. So just go to the $job and create a new folder called cache, and we'll just give a directory name as source. And here in the file name, you can create source. $f4.vgo.sc. and accept it. So now we'll just save to the disk. That will take some time. So now as you can see, it is, the color is transferring from 13th frame. So as you can see, so the points are beautifully scattering from frame 13. So as I said, the color is transparent from frame 13. So the scatter will also so if you want you can just you can just delete the channel and you can just save to disk from frame 13. So it is coming from the starting because I haven't deleted from frame 1 to 12, so just delete the unnecessary frames and just check load from disk. And now we will take a fluid source. So you can see there is no fluid source over here. So now there is a pyro source, so how we will bring the legacy nodes. So just go to the Windows and here you will find Xscript export. So in here you just type open hide SOP and just type the node you want to bring in. So I want fluid source. And just press enter. Ignore this error. And now you can see we have fluid source, the legacy one. So we'll be working with the legacy. So now as you can see, we just give it to stamp points. And now it has generated the STF or it has generated the volumes. So just adjust the sample distance in the tab stamp points. So you can see now the fluid source is also animating because the scatter points are animating. So we'll take source fuel because we want to create fires. So now it is looking. So we have taken source fuel. So we have fuel and temperature. And we'll increase the resolution. So we'll keep the division size to 0.04. So for now, let's keep it to default. And just create a null. And give it as a name as source, or you can dop source because it will go into the dop, and give it a black color. So usually I give nulls to the black color so it is easy to identify. So now we have created our fluid source and see you in the next class. Thank you.